Why would you?
Pull your pants up.
Hey, Jeff.
What's up, Adele?
Where's the gang? What'd that cop want?
I don't know. He was just bored.
Did he ask you to pull up your pants?
Of course.
Original. Probably the weirdest thing he's ever said.
It's like what Orwell said. We all live in a giant machine. We're nothing but numbers. No one needs to torture me to behave. No cage of rats around my head. I have no choice but to behave.
All right.
See that guy? He thinks stewardesses like him. But that's just how they treat everybody in business class. He had a brief affair with the secretary in Chicago before things got too weird. I mean, he loves his wife, but he hasn't had sex with her in 6 years. Since they had the last son. He's been dating underwear models ever since.
Dinner's almost ready.
It all started with the lingerie catalogs in the study while his wife was making tuna sandwiches and his daughter was practicing the trumpet. He started recognizing lingerie models in the different catalogs. He would create different scenarios in his mind. Ski trips, the Mile High Club. He recognizes the girl in that lingerie poster over there. That's the one he saw in another catalog. The one who likes to wear the sun don't shine.
What about her?
Oh, she just quit smoking. Yeah, yesterday she ate a whole pint of ice cream by herself. While her kids were taking a nap and her husband was watching the monster truck show. Then she went digging in the garbage for cigarette butts and she found one. She looks at herself every night in the full-length mirror. She still thinks she's sexy. But her husband doesn't. He doesn't understand her appetite. Sugar makes her feel better.
God, shoot me if I ever end up like that.
She thinks about picking up complete strangers and fucking them in motel rooms, and she knows one night she's going to, but hey, at least she's gotten over her drinking problem. She hasn't had an episode since that dinner party last year.
The Steppenwolf that I often call myself. That beast astray that finds neither home, nor joy, nor nourishment in a world that is strange and incomprehensible to him.
What about this guy?
You want to sell the cobblestone hills? Do it. Just send me a visit.
He inherited the tuxedo store from his old man 20 years ago. He hates tuxes almost as much as he hates his life. But he knows the business. He knows that when a tux loses its luster, he can sell it to a store in a shabbier neighborhood.
It's good.
No notice that most guys are only gonna wear a tux twice in their life. Once at their prom. And once at their kid's wedding. He's cornered the market on both of them. He had a pointless and awkward affair with the girl who does his books. He even fucked her the night before her wedding, which gave him a nice little ego boost. But those days are long gone.
Jeff. Yo. What's up? What you doing, man? You smoking?
Tomorrow. Asshole.
Fire. I can't do that.
Fuck, you'll get laid, Jeff. life-changing moments, Joe.
I am not the coward in the woods with the gun. He is stuck in his man-wolf dichotomy. I am made up of many more elements than that. I am not stuck. I am unstuck.
This is the first line here. This is the first line again. Watch as it disappears. I know the last line. The last line.
One day, I would learn how to laugh.